The shield is back. Zul and I had some fun messing around with it, and I felt you deserved a video about it before I went to bed. In Danger Zone, you can start with it, or you can buy it for $500. This is what it looks like when it arrives, just in case you were wondering. Not exactly discreet packaging. Use the console command, give weapon underscore shield, if you want to test it out in your spare time. When not in use, it sits on your back and protects you from any shots that hit it. Not even the AWP can penetrate it. Be careful though. Bullets can still pass through the bit you see through, and your legs will always be exposed. Crouching makes things even worse, revealing a bit of your ass to anybody sneaking up behind you. Having it equipped changes the situation somewhat. You can see here what's exposed and from where. Crouching will hide pretty much your whole body, though your foot remains exposed unless you look down so far that your head pops over the top. Plus, they can still shoot you through the face hole. Don't Pikachu face if you get shot while behind the shield. Expect it. When equipped, you'll be unable to use any weapons. Instead, pressing fire will result in a melee attack with the same range as a knife. It inflicts 50 damage against unarmored players, and 25 if they have a vest. You'll only be able to run at 200 units a second if you have a shield, even if it's unequipped. And when equipped, your walking speed drops to just 170 units per second, which is slower than any weapon in the game, apart from the Negev and when scoped in or firing the R8. You'll still be able to jump just as high with it as without. Be warned that players will still be able to shoot through the hole in it. Bit of a design flaw if you ask me. It can eventually be broken. It has 650 health and the calculation is base damage times by how good the gun is at wallbanging. Oddly, armor penetration doesn't play a part in the calculation at all. You can work it out for each weapon using Sloth Squadrons and Black Retina's spreadsheet, link in the description. As you'd expect, snipers are the best, but you might be surprised to know that the AWP and the SSG-08 both take 3 shots at close range to break it, while the autos will take 4. And so will the SSG-08 once you get to ranges where the fog starts to pick up a bit. You may also not expect shotguns to do as well as they do. At range, they'll be useless. But up close, you can get through a shield in 3 shots. The XM1014 is a bit weaker though, taking 6. The revolver takes 4 shots, the Deagle takes 6. Rifles and machine guns will all take 10 or more shots. And for pistols and SMGs, you're talking 20 or more shots. When dropped on the floor, it's invincible. And it no longer blocks all damage, only against some weapons. Let's face it, if you want something to hide behind, use proper cover, and not a shield that's intended to be carried. Interestingly, a knife doesn't even notice the shield's there, and will go straight through, even if the shield is equipped by the player at the time. So, with most weapons, you can destroy the shield in a single magazine. But remember, this is Danger Zone. For most of the match, your ammo will be limited, so although you may be able to break the shield, would you want to spend all your ammo doing so? Or would you rather run off and find somebody else to fight instead? Now I see why the shield suits Danger Zone. Its role has more depth to it than meets the eye. In conclusion, yeah, it's a shield. It won't make you invincible, but it will make you a hell of a lot harder to hit if used properly. You're slow and defenseless with it equipped, so I think it'll be best used passively, sat on your back, soaking up damage from behind you. It'll lead to weird tactics, like facing away from an enemy as you dash for cover, or spinning 180 degrees as you have to reload a weapon mid-fight. 360 degree no scopes might actually work. The fact that simply having it in your inventory slows you down will limit its usefulness, but I am excited to see it utilized in CSGO, and I think that Danger Zone is the perfect place for it.